Good evening and welcome to our Autumn Equinox service. We're delighted to welcome you, whether you are here physically or you are tuning in virtually, comfortably, wherever you are, to the beloved community of Unity Atlanta. We are so delighted to have reached this time of the year, to have reached another season, and I'm delighted to welcome back GabrielNelson Sears. If you are like many of us, it seems that it was just the springtime and we were figuring out how to live in new ways, and now here we are in another season. We are here to welcome in that season of autumn and to know together that the seasons remind us of the continuity of life that flows in, around, and through all things. And so as we welcome you, invite you wherever you are to be as comfortable as you can be as we share together in these times of prayer and meditation and the beautiful healing sounds that GabrielNelson shares with us, that we allow ourselves to move in body, mind, and spirit fully into this beautiful season. So let us begin as we do all things with prayer. Beloved Creator God, we give thanks for this time that we have reached this place, that we can feel ourselves grounded in those truths, that we know that one power and one presence in the universe and in our lives that moves in, around, and through all things. We affirm whoever we are, wherever we are, the sanctity of all human life, that divine expression of God. We each are here to be in this world. We allow this season of autumn to be a time where we embrace the beauty of the harvest of our lives, as well as that gentle release, like a beautiful leaf whirl on a wind that reminds us that even as things pass away, the beauty and richness of the spirit of this natural world give us comfort, bring us joy, and grant us peace. Whoever we are, wherever we are, may we know the comfort, the joy, the peace, and especially the wonder of this rich season. For this and so many blessings in our lives, we are truly grateful. Amen.
Good evening. Thank you, Reverend Jen, for inviting me back. It's always wonderful to be in community again with you here at Unity Atlanta and celebrating the cooler weather and the fall equinox. As we think about the equinox and go into our first extended meditation this evening, let us bring into that a reflection on that which we have brought forth manifest in this year. What are your crops? What are your accomplishments? And let us celebrate on the wings of the Himalayan singing bowls as we reflect and give thanks.
I am reading a classic daily word from Autumn 2003 for Fall Equinox, September 23rd, 2020. The daily word for today is Gifts of Autumn. The affirmation is, in this autumn season, I reap an abundant harvest of God's blessings. The scripture is from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11. God makes everything suitable for its time. The reading says, in some parts of the world, autumn brings welcome changes. The air turns from hot and muggy to crisp and clear. Lush green leaves take on a surprising brilliance and a dazzling array of colors before they are gently released to nourish the still, warm earth below. Autumn represents a time to express my ingenuity and talents, to reap an abundant harvest from my previous efforts, to prepare for a time of celebrating God's blessings. Soon this season will be followed by one of rest, introspection, and re-energizing for a time of new growth. A season of autumn may appear in the progression of my spiritual growth or in the process of a long-term project. Whenever I experience an autumn season, I give thanks for the rich lessons and gifts from God to me. Again, the daily word for today is Gifts of Autumn. And the affirmation is, in this autumn season, I reap an abundant harvest of God's blessings. Namaste.
This is a reading called Autumn, the Season of Paradox. It was written in 2011 by Christine Walters Paintner. The autumn equinox is the time of year when the sun rests above the equator, and day and night are divided equally. It heralds a season filled with change, celebrates the harvest, and ushers in the brilliant beauty of death. Autumn is a season of transition, of continual movement. At the heart of autumn's gifts are these twin energies of relinquishing and harvesting. It is a season of paradox that invites us to consider what we are called to release and surrender. And at the same time, it invites us to gather in the harvest, to name and celebrate the fruits of the seeds we planted months ago. In holding these two in tension, we are reminded that in our letting go, we also find abundance. As I walk each day, fall offers solace with her unbearable beauty. But some days the wind gusts through and the trees are stripped bare. I weep at the ache I feel when I consider how everything I love in this world will one day die. The season calls me to let go of false assumptions, rest my two small images of God from me as I enter the mystery of dying and rising. Autumn demands that I release what I think is important to do and returns me to the only thing which matters, that I remember to love and to allow love to sculpt me even as it breaks my heart. But equally, this season calls us to the harvest. Seeds planted long ago create a bounty and fullness in our lives. Autumn invites me to remember the places in my life where I had a dream that once felt tiny and has now grown and ripened into fullness. I savor these places where my life feels abundant. I relish the experience of being nourished by dreams into my own growing wholeness. The poet Rilke writes of autumn, "Command the last fruits to be full. Give them just two more southern days. Urge them on to completion and chase the last sweetness into the heavy wine." We move towards our own ripening, and in that journey, we let go of what no longer serves us. Fall urges us on to our own completion and sweetness. We live in times when it often feels like everything is coming undone. This season reminds us that the journey of relinquishing all we hold dear is also the journey of harvesting. Somehow, these two come together year after year. We are invited to rest into its mystery. What are you releasing that no longer energizes you? What dreams do you want to harvest this season?
So much of life is a paradox, those twin energies. And that's part of the beauty of life. The deeper our love, the deeper our grief when we lose someone. They're the same flip sides of that same coin. And so this evening, we're going to move into a gong meditation. And the gong is the perfect sound instrument to help release that which no longer serves us, to help compost and make room, both the internal space and the space in our lives and of those around us. So I'd like to invite you to close your eyes And also know that the gong at the end of this meditation will go into 5 minutes of silence so that you can reconfigure, or in computer talk, your disk defrag gets all put back together again. So just close your eyes and sink into that heart space and breathe and release.
Thank you.
Gently bring yourselves back. Feel your heart, your body, the chair, and give thanks for that which has been released, making space for more abundance. And know that the gong medicine will continue to do its magic for the next couple of days.
Thank you.
feel that energy, that vibration of sound moving in, around, and through us, releasing what no longer needs to be in us, in body, in mind, or in spirit, making way for that rich and wondrous harvest that is about to come forth for each of us in our own divine way. And we are so grateful for Gabriel Nelson being back with us, for the beautiful readings from our prayer chaplain, Frieda Stewart, and from our Earth Care team leader, Beth Remus, to remind us of the gifts of this season. And we are so grateful for the gifts that you share with us in whatever way you do, a tithe, a love offering, a pledge, a show of support to say thank you, Unity Atlanta, for reminding me that even as I am releasing and letting go, I am reaping a rich and wondrous harvest. And so in whatever way feels comfortable for you to give, we have a text to give option. We have Cash App and Venmo that we are using now. We have the Give Spot on our website that you can go to. And of course, the money order or check, if we're also liking to write it out and release and know that as we give, so more as that water we saw on the image flows to us. And we're so grateful. We thank you for those gifts. And know that there is a beloved community wherever you are that you can now tune into via live stream. You don't have to be in Atlanta anymore just to enjoy all the gifts that we have to share with you in our beloved community of Unity Atlanta. And so if you have a gift, we'd love to receive it, and we'd love to affirm our offering blessing with you. Divine love through me blesses and increases all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I have. I give in love because I am love, and I love to give. Thank you, God. Amen. We are grateful for another season to have reached this point in our lives. Wherever you are, know that we love you, we bless you, we appreciate the gift of life you are, and we behold the presence of God as you. May all your releasing be easy and gentle, and may you reap the beauty and the joy of a rich, ripe harvest. Blessings to all. Namaste.
Namaste.